Hello everybody, I'm Tarun, co-founder of Firefly. Recently we've been looking at resilience as a very important skill, especially in times like this. So what is resilience? Resilience is the ability to adapt to adverse changes and be flexible enough to come out with a solution, right? So, but do you know that there are a lot of thinking traps we put ourselves through and which come against resilience? So, you know, there are a lot of thinking traps, but we look at the top five ones, okay? The first one being mind reading. Mind reading is something when you assume that you know what the others are thinking, and you know, it's usually not something which is very positive. You assume that others are thinking negative things about you, and that's not how you want to objectively look at the situation, especially in times of crisis, right? The second thinking trap is called me thinking, right? Or we can now even call it the me trap, wherein we look at ourselves as the sole cause for the problem, which leads to a lot of guilt and disappointment. The third thinking trap is them trap, right? In this case, what really happens is you look at one person as the sole cause for the problem, and that leads to again a lot of anger and resentment. So me thinking and them thinking is kind of similar. When you put the blame on one person, it could be either you or a different person, and both are coming in the way of the actual solution that can happen if you're not thinking like this. The fourth thinking trap is catastrophizing. In this case, you are just overthinking and imagining the worst possible case scenario, which is very irrational. That might never happen at all, but just because you're overthinking, you're assuming that will happen. Again, that is a very negative way of looking at things, especially in times of crisis. Finally, the fifth one is called helplessness. In this case, you look at a problem and you are assuming again that this problem will ruin everything, you know, everything, every aspect of your life, be it your career, be it your personal life, be it your health, be it everything, right? So all these five thinking traps can also be like a spectrum, but the important point to notice here is to be aware that, you know, we are facing these thinking traps, and you know, that's half the battle won. For example, even when I face certain crisis, I also definitely think of myself in certain traps. But if I'm aware of that I'm falling in those traps, it's easier for me to get out of it, right? This has actually been inspired by Dr. Karen Dreivick's work from University of Pennsylvania. And we've been working with a lot of companies and teams to build the skill of resilience. So if you really want to learn more, reach out to us. Thanks a lot.